Condyloma acuminatum or genital wart is a very common HPV-related lesion, and it is associated with low-risk HPV infection. Predominantly, it is caused by the serotypes 6 and 11, or low-risk HPV subtypes. It is very common sexually transmitted disease. It affects both men and women, and it typically affects anogenital region. These lesions tend to recur, and they usually do not progress to high-grade lesions or carcinoma. Macroscopically, condylomas looks like exophytic cauliflower-like wart lesions, and they can be very small, but sometimes they can measure more than 5 centimeters in the case of giant condyloma. Under the microscope, we can see these papilloma-like polypoid structure lined by acanthotic stratified squamous epithelium. Acanthosis is the term used to describe the thickening of the epidermis. These papillary structures have prominent fibrovascular cores. And on the higher magnification, we can see this acanthotic stratified squamous epithelium with well-circumscribed basal layer, which creates these slightly bulbous prominences. On the surface, we see parakeratosis, which means that the nuclei are retained in the superficial layer. And quite typical morphological feature of the condyloma is coilocytic transformation of the epithelial cells. That's what we see here. Coilocytes are the cells with slightly irregular, slightly atypical larger nucleus with a halo in the cytoplasm around the nucleus. So all of these cells, those are coilocytes. This is the morphological effect of the active viral infection. The maturation in the epithelium is often disrupted. It means that in layers closer to the surface, we don't see the small nuclei. The nuclei are still quite large, and the cells looks like they are from the basal or parabasal layers. Nuclear to cytoplasmic ratio is, however, quite low, and the high-grade dysplastic features are not seen. Here we see the typical 2 nuclei in one cell, which is quite often seen in case of condyloma. So this is the typical appearance of the condyloma or genital wart, and thanks for watching.